everyone, Shabby Game here, and we are back with another championship tournament here for our 2K16 Universe Mode for the Attitude Era. Now, I will just say quickly that at the beginning of this video, there is no Universe Mode footage in this video. This is just going to be our Cruiserweight Championship tournament to crown our first champion going into our Universe Mode. Hopefully, the first episode of this will be uploaded next Friday. So let's have a quick look at the guys that are in this tournament for you. We've got Rey Mysterio and Christian. Tajiri and Jushin Thunder Liger, Dean Malenko and X-Pac, and Mikey Whipwreck and Eddie Guerrero. Now, just for a little bit of fun, why don't we nip down to the comment section below and basically take a guess who you think is going to win this competition. I'm going to go for the obvious one. I'm going to go for Rey Mysterio, I think. I think this is going to be a very even competition, actually, because you've got Rey Mysterio and Christian. Anybody could win this. They really can. I'm not fancying Mikey Whipwreck to win it, which probably means he will, but I'm going to say Rey, hopefully. And here we go, the first of the first round matches. It's Rey Mysterio taking on Christian. And here we go, and I'm so glad this Rey Mysterio is finally working. I had a few issues with this core. I don't know what it was, but for some reason it kept changing all of the logos on his body, well, all his tattoos, essentially, to other random logos I had in my in my download. So I'm not quite sure why. I think it replaced his chest tattoo with the James Storm logo. It replaced his legs with this stuff from Asuka's trunks. It was really random. And I think this, like the other Rey Mysterio, it looks absolutely fine in the loading screen, it looks absolutely fine in the Creator Wrestler screen. For some reason, it has a lump on his forehead again, I think. I can't quite see it from this angle, but yeah, it looks like he's got a lump on his forehead. So that's a bit annoying, but there you go. Like I say, Rey Mysterio is my favorite for this tournament. Again, if you guys haven't already, then be sure to nip down to the comment section below and have your guess. Would it be Rey Mysterio, Christian, Tajiri, Jushin Thunder, Jushin Liger, Dean Malenko, X-Pac, Mikey Whipwreck, or Eddie Guerrero? It's going to be a fantastic tournament, this one, again. It's another very strong tournament, and that just shows how good this Attitude Era roster is going to be this year. As people are staring at me through my front window. Maybe I should put some clothes on. Who knows? There you go. I am actually wearing clothes. If that's freaked any of you out there for a second, I am actually wearing clothes. I just did that for a... I said it for a joke as people were staring at me. Rey Mysterio with the drop in the elbow to the inside of the knee of Christian there. Bringing him back up to his feet. Great tornado, tilt-a-whirl, and loads of other stuff. Head scissors. Really taking the mick there is Eddie Guerrero, as Rey Mysterio, sorry. And of course, we have had a random match already in this series between Eddie Guerrero and Rey Mysterio. It's one of my most watched videos. That's that could potentially be one of our finals this evening. Of course, a lot of things have to go our way for that to happen, but it's a distinct possibility that could be a great final. I'm saying that all the guys in this competition could give us an absolutely fantastic final. Of course, I think Rey Mysterio is also going to work for Global Force Wrestling as well. Since he has been released by WWE now in real life, current day sort of stuff. So he will be working for Global Force Wrestling, just to add another top main eventer, really, to Global Force's roster. And a Mexican legend as well, who could definitely get involved in a few feuds. Christian, of course, is going to be... I'm not sure whether we might actually use Christian at some point in the current day roster as well. I think he's been moved very quietly. I think he's been moved to the retired section of WWE's website, but... I'm sure we might be able to bring him back at some point. Maybe we could bring back Edge for a little bit of time as well. Maybe bring them back as a tag team or something along them lines. Maybe we could do some sort of surprise. Maybe the New Day can be out there challenging tag teams or issuing an open challenge, and Edge and Christian could make their way out. That could be an interesting one to do. Like I say, there's so many possibilities of things we could do. As Rey Mysterio throwing Christian to the outside, we're going to see our first dive of the tournament. We do! It's a big dive over the top. Rey Mysterio catches Christian. Christian's down and out. Can Mysterio capitalize on the damage done here? He brings Christian back to his feet. Went for a spinning heel kick, but Christian avoids it. Christian now with a big punch to the stomach and then a boot to the stomach as well. Neck breaker on Rey Mysterio. Brings Rey back up to his feet. And there's a flapjack by Christian on Mysterio as well. Christian bringing Mysterio back up to his feet. Boot to the stomach. Jawbreaker by Mysterio on Christian. And Mysterio slides back into the ring. Christian joins him back in there as well, both avoiding the referee's count. Christian back in control of this match, though, throwing Mysterio into the corner, now taking him up onto the top turnbuckle. I remember, like in all my tournaments, damage retention is on, so these guys want to get through this first round as unscathed as possible, because they know it's a very difficult second round match. In the all-Japanese match, the second round match, isn't it? That is... in the second first round match, sorry, that's Jushin Liger versus Tajiri, an all-Japanese match. That's going to be pretty good as well. A different Jushin Liger than the one I used in my random match as well. This is one looks a little bit better. Just the first one I think I had was missing a couple of bits of detail. This one has got a lot more detail, and I think it's going to look great. And it's going to be, again, Jushin Liger is going to be someone that we use. I'm thinking of having Jushin Liger in Attitude Era. I think we're going to have him in the retro roster as well. As Rey Mysterio almost picks up the victory. Yeah, we're going to have him in the Attitude Era as part of the Cruiserweight division. Of course, I think he was involved in the late 90s, maybe mid to late 90s, in the Cruiserweight division in WCW anyway. And I think he was actually made a... no, he didn't make any appearances in WWE, did he? But he was involved in WCW, which is why I've got him involved here in this competition here this evening. We'll be involved in the retro roster as well, Jushin Liger. It's going to be a team alongside the great Muta, I think. In that retro roster, and then of course he will be heavily involved in Global Force Wrestling as well. Going to be sort of at the top end of the roster this year, rather than being... I think last year I had him involved... no, last year I didn't really use him at all, did I really? But this year I think we're going to use him as more of a top end star, hoping helping to put some of the younger guys over, and maybe even fighting out for the Intercontinental and even Global Championship at some point as well. And then of course we might use him for a little wander back into NXT, maybe, just like William Regal did with the Tyler Breeze situation. So that's something we could do. Surprise opponent for somebody. Christian now throwing Rey Mysterio into the ring steps. Christian's giving up on fighting fair now. He's just using his environment to his advantage. Slamming Mysterio into the ring steps and now just stamping on the back of Mysterio's legs. Maybe Christian could get back in the ring and hopefully try and win this one by count out, but... there you go, now Christian throwing Mysterio into the barrier there with some force. And remember, in our European Championship tournament, we saw a dodgy count-out victory in the first round, and that's what Christian's hoping for here. Mysterio struggling. He's back up to his feet. The referee's up to an 8, and Mysterio slides back in. Christian was taunting there, and I think he might end up regretting that as Mysterio spins all the way around him. There's the head scissors. Mysterio goes up to the top rope. Big, he almost hit the frog splash there. 1, 2. Oh, and Christian kicks out on the verge of a free count. Christian was taunting there. Rey Mysterio caught him and almost picked up the victory from that frog splash. Mysterio with another Hurricanrana. Rotating leg drop as well by Mysterio. Brings Christian back up to his feet. Sends him into that far corner. What's Mysterio got planned here? Christian with a big boot to the face, though. Now takes Mysterio up into the backdrop. And I picked Mysterio as my choice to win this competition, which probably means he's going to get knocked out in the first round to Christian here anyway. That's generally happens with my choices. I'm no William. William seems to be getting a lot of them right at the moment. I can't get a single one right. Christian now in with a pin. 1, 2. And there we go. There we go. Just like I said, my choice, Rey Mysterio, eliminated. And Christian is going through to our semi-final here this evening to fight it out for that Cruiserweight Championship here in the Attitude Era roster. And I can't believe it. Every time, every single time I pick someone to win these competitions, they always lose. What am I doing to like offend people so much that I can't get a single one right? But of course, Christian's going to have a very difficult second round. He's going to have to face off against the winner of our all-Japanese tournament match. We've got, obviously, Tajiri facing off against Jushin Liger. That's going to be an interesting one. You see the big dive there by Mysterio over the top rope on Christian. And I thought the damage had been done there by Mysterio. I thought he could have picked up the victory. Evidently not, though.
Christian looked a bit dead on his feet at this point in the match, but he still managed to hit a Frankensteiner, a move we saw a few times in the Intercontinental Championship tournament by Christian. But that was only enough for a two count at that point in the match anyway. And Christian picking up the victory. I don't know, he didn't really hit a big impactful move to finish it off. It must have been a combination of big moves that finished him off. There's that reverse DDT, pulling Mysterio into the middle of the ring. Like I say, it wasn't really a big move which finally finished Mysterio off, but it was enough to keep him down. I think the damage must have been done earlier on, and that reverse DDT was just the last straw that broke the camel's back. So Christian is victorious. He is going on to our second round later on this evening, our semi-finals later on this evening. Who is going to be his opponent? We're going to find out next. And here we go with the second of our first round matches this evening. It's going to be Tajiri versus Jushin Thunder Liger. And here we go, Tajiri and Jushin Liger in our first round match here. An all-Japanese first round match as well. And you see this Jushin Liger does look a lot better than the one we had earlier on in our random match series. The first one we had looks pretty good, but this one just looks... It just has it's had all the detail, I think. I think that first one was missing a couple of bits here and there. And of course, like I said, Tajiri was involved in the Cruiserweight Championship division in real life as well. Jushin Thunder Liger, I'm pretty sure, was involved in the Cruiserweight division over in WCW in the mid to late 90s, I think around the 97, 98 mark maybe. I might be wrong, but that's why we've got him involved in this tournament here this evening. There are other guys that will be involved, such as Brian Kendrick and Paul London. They're going to be in there, and La Parca as well, but I need to change La Parca because the game seems to have him set down as not a Cruiserweight. I'm pretty sure he probably is not really a Cruiserweight body style wise, but I want to have him as part of the Cruiserweight division. Big back elbow there by Tajiri on Jushin Liger. And by having Jushin Liger here again, it just allows us something a little bit different. Something a little bit extra to what we'd normally have on our Attitude Era roster. Just a different... just have a more of a Japanese influence. Of course, we have got Tajiri, who will be involved in the Cruiserweight and the Hardcore divisions. And maybe even the Tag Team division as well. I did mention earlier about the possibility of maybe having some sort of Raven's Flock. Involving Raven, obviously, the leader, and then maybe Mikey Whipwreck and Tajiri as the sort of guys in there as well. So I'm not quite sure on that one yet. It's a possibility. It's something that we're thinking about. Jushin Liger now with a big blow across the back of the head. Tajiri goes down. Tajiri back up with a dragon screw. Beautiful move by Tajiri. And of course, my pick for this tournament is already out. Rey Mysterio lost to Christian in the first round. Tajiri now only a one count over Jushin Liger. Tajiri the dropkick to the back of the head now. And of course, we only have one more championship tournament to do after this. And that is going to be our tag team championship. After that, I'm going to go straight onto Global Force Wrestling, I think, over the next couple of days. And then we'll finish off with Ring of Honor over the weekend. Probably on Saturday I'll upload the Ring of Honor one, and then we'll do all of our introduction episodes as well, which would be pretty good. It'd be nice to show you guys finally who is on my rosters, what sort of tag teams we've got, and who all the champions are as well, of course. So if you've missed some of these championship tournaments and you haven't got time to watch them all, then don't worry, I will be telling you in those videos exactly who won all the belts. Great Liger bomb there by Jushin Liger. It's early, but he could pick up the victory here. Rolls Tajiri over into the pin. One, two. No, it's only a one count. I've noticed that a bit more in the game recently. They seem to be doing quite a bit of this. They'll people seem to get their finishes very early on, and then they don't seem strong enough to actually win the match that early on. As Tajiri locking in the tarantula on Jushin Liger. Great move by Tajiri. Liger now sending Tajiri into that corner, face first. Oh, back elbow by Tajiri. And Liger catches him in that Fez press. Not a very Cruiserweight style move, but it's effective nonetheless.
Liger, he needs to capitalize on that damage done. Finally brings Tajiri in for the pin. One, two. It's only a two count. Big boot across the back by Liger onto Tajiri, now stamping on the chest as well. Tajiri there tripping Liger over, now brings him back up to his feet. And there's the green miss by Tajiri. The green miss by Tajiri. But he doesn't do anything to capitalize on it. Why has he not done anything to capitalize on it? That's rather annoying. And Liger continues the assault himself, locking in that grounded headlock on Tajiri, slowing the match down, allowing him a few seconds to get over what's just happened. Oh, that's really annoying.
It's really annoying. My battery on my controller's just died. How unprofessional was that? Is it back on now? Are we back in? We're in. Okay.
Let's just completely pretend that never happened. Right. So we continue onwards with this match now. Like nothing happened. Liger with that snap suplex. Odd Tajiri. In for the pin. One. Two. Oh, it's only a one count. It is only a one count there by Tajiri on Jushin Liger. Liger now brings Tajiri back up to his feet, but Tajiri fights back with the uppercut. And both these guys are really starting to come into it a bit more now. Tajiri has, of course, hit that green mist, and Liger has also hit his Liger bomb. Both guys managed to survive them. Tajiri looking for a belly-to-belly suplex, but Liger fights out with those punches to the face. Now sending Tajiri into that corner. Tajiri with that back elbow. And a big kick to the face as well. Liger with that knee to the face on Tajiri. Spins him round. And dropping him face first into the mat. High impact move there by Liger on Tajiri. Now something random tries to load up my computer. We'll cancel that. I don't know what it is. Liger takes Tajiri up. Is this going to be the brainbuster? It is. It's the brainbuster. Liger in for the pin. One, two, and three. Jushin Thunder Liger's going on to face Christian in our semi-final here this evening for a chance to fight it out for the Cruiserweight Championship in our main event. So you see some of the highlights. There's Tajiri with a tarantula. See Liger throwing Tajiri into the corner. Tajiri with that back elbow. And there was that Fez press by Liger. Like I said, not a normal move for many Cruiserweights, but it was effective nonetheless. There's Liger with that snap suplex on Tajiri again. Went for the pin off that, but it was only enough for a two count. You see here Liger just stalking the grounded Tajiri. Takes him up. And there it is, the brainbuster brings him down hard. In for the free count. So Jushin Liger is victorious. He's going on to face Christian in our semi-final later on this evening for a chance to fight it out for the Cruiserweight Championship in our main event. But who will be joining them in them semi-finals? We're going to find out next. And here is the third of our first round matches. It's going to be Dean Malenko taking on X-Pac. And here we go. First time we're going to see Dean Malenko in any of my videos, really. Not really used him. It took me a while to download him because I had to, for some reason, I had to download the Arnold Schwarzenegger package before you could have Dean Malenko. Not quite sure why. I'm just assuming there's probably something on Dean Malenko that is only available as part of the Arnie package, but there you go. Either way, we've finally got him now, and I think it's going to be pretty good to have this guy. Obviously, again, one of the most underrated wrestlers in history, I believe. Of course, we're going to have him as a part of a tag team alongside Eddie Guerrero as well. That's going to be the Radicals. I might bring in Perry Saturn at some point as well, and maybe even Chris Benoit. I'm not quite sure what your guys' opinions are of Chris Benoit. I know, obviously, I don't condone anything he did outside the ring. It's an absolute travesty what he did outside the ring, but at the end of the day, what he was inside the ring was an absolutely incredible wrestler, and I don't think we can, I don't think we should forget about that, really. He was a fantastic in-ring competitor, and no matter what he did outside the ring, it doesn't take away from what he did inside the ring, if that makes sense. And again, same thing, no matter what he did inside the ring, doesn't take away what he did outside the ring. You sort of get what I mean. It's a bit like Hulk Hogan as well. As much as he said some very, very stupid things outside the ring, as far as I'm concerned, he was still a very important part of 1980s and 1990s wrestling era. Without Hulk Hogan, wrestling probably wouldn't have been as big as it is. So as much as you'd like to try and fade Hulk Hogan out because of stupid things he said, at the same time, you can't really forget about him, because without him, wrestling wouldn't be the same as it is now. And it's the same thing with Benoit, really. He was the he was one of the first little men to ever be given a great chance, really. I don't know. There were quite a few sort of little men who got a chance, but Benoit was just, he was a difference. It was Benoit and Guerrero both got their chances pretty much the same sort of time, and it was great to see them finally getting their chances. And no matter what he did outside the ring, you can't really take away from how great of a wrestler he was inside the ring as well. Of course, X-Pac has some troubled things that he's done as well, so nobody, I don't think most people in the WWE are completely clean of everything. Let's just say that for a start. Of course, Vince and Triple H were pretty heavily into their steroids as well at some point, so as you can tell, because, well, you just have to take one look at Vince and say, fucking hell, he's nearly 70 years old and he's built like a brick shithouse. So it's difficult, really. It really is. Yeah, let me know what you think. Whether you think using Benoit would be a bad idea, or whether you think it'd be okay, or I've sort of kept away from him from now just because I don't want to really offend anybody. If I was playing the game for myself, I probably would use him. Like I said, no matter what he did outside the ring, you can't take away from how great of a wrestler he was inside the ring. So that's my sort of idea on that. But yeah, it's pretty much down to what you guys really want, to tell the truth. Perry Saturn, nothing wrong with having Perry Saturn in there. I just don't know if we'd use him that much. Obviously, Guerrero and Malenko, I think, we'll definitely use, so it's probably definitely worth having them. Guys like Perry Saturn, we probably wouldn't use at all, to tell the honest truth. He'd probably be involved in the Hardcore Championship, maybe the European at a stretch, but it might be a waste of a core, maybe, if we don't use him that much. X-Pac with a pin. And X-Pac nearly pulls off the victory over Dean Malenko here. Malenko sends X-Pac over the top of his shoulders, now sends him off that rope. Malenko with the German suplex, beautiful move. Malenko went for the big chop, he missed it. X-Pac with the snapmare, went for the drop kick to the back on Malenko, but Malenko avoids it. Malenko now sending X-Pac into the corner. Can he follow up on this? X-Pac with the big boots, the face. And Malenko is one of my favourites for this competition. I really like Malenko. I'm sure a few of you do out there as well. I've had a couple of comments requesting Malenko as well, so I'm sure a few of you guys actually like him as well. And I really do hope he does well in this tournament, especially since my pick, Rey Mysterio, has been eliminated. Malenko kicks out after a one count there. X-Pac can't believe it. X-Pac now taking Malenko onto them ropes and sends him off the far rope. What's he got planned here? Oh, Malenko manages the reverse, sending X-Pac over the top of his shoulders once again, and there's a drop kick by Malenko on X-Pac. Hey, remember, we are running two Cruiserweight Championships across our universe, but we're going to have one in the current day roster as well. We've already crowned that champion, which you can find. Of course, if you nip down to the description below, you will find a link to all of the playlists in this universe mode. If you're watching this video maybe a week or two in the future, then every single playlist should now be teeming with lots of lovely videos for you to watch, including our first weekly episode of every universe mode. But at the moment, if you're watching this on the day I've uploaded this, of course you can check out all the WWE Championship tournaments, all the retro ones, and all of NXT as well. They're all uploaded so far. There's only one more left for this roster. That's going to be the Tag Team Championship Tournament. That should be uploaded straight after this video, hopefully. And then obviously Ring of Honor and Global Force I'll be doing over the next couple of days. Get them out of the way and then we can start with our weekly shows. And of course, if you are interested at all, I am uploading Fallout 4 videos as well. I'm up to about, probably up to about 7 or 8 on that now in the series. I've uploaded quite a few videos over the first few days, really because I just wanted to get as much into the game as I possibly can, and I still don't think I've scratched the surface. I've played the game now for about 6 or 7 hours, and we haven't really scratched the surface on what there is to do yet, so I'm really looking forward to getting further into that. Big punt to the back by Dean Malenko, and of course you can find that on my channel as well, the Fallout 4 videos. At the moment my poor computer is just on constantly, just either, well, I've got my computer here that I'm recording on, then my laptop next to it is constantly just editing and uploading at the same time now. I've been constantly uploading videos for the last few days, all through the night and everything like that, because it does take quite a while to upload these videos. Dean Malenko now with that great submission hold here by Dean Malenko. And that's what I was saying, such an underrated wrestler is Dean Malenko. X-Pac fights his way free. And a slap by X-Pac, just showing a lack of respect to Dean Malenko. In for the pin. One, two, no, only a one count. Of course, there's also the possibility this evening that we could have the Radicals, the tag team, the Radicals, going against each other in that semi-final. Should Malenko win this and Eddie Guerrero defeat Mikey Whipwreck, there's a very good chance that could happen. Great Hurricanrana there by X-Pac. X-Pac bringing Malenko back up to his feet. In for that quick roll-up, but Malenko's arms are underneath the rope. The referee was, I don't know, the referee seemed to be knocked down there. He was knocked against the ropes. I'm not quite sure. I didn't see when that happened. X-Pac with a reverse DDT on Malenko. Now makes his way up onto the top rope. Are we going to see some high impact move here by X-Pac? There's the leg drop from the top rope. And X-Pac to the outside. What's he got planned here? Slides back into the ring. And there are some, there are some dodgy AI decisions. I know 2K said they improved the AI, but there seems to be the odd dodgy AI decision every now and again. That was one of them. Dean Malenko. There's the butterfly powerbomb on X-Pac. That could be all. One, two, and three. And that is Dean Malenko defeats X-Pac, and he is going through to our semi-final here this evening. And I think I'm losing my voice slightly. Oh, that's better. That's a bit in my throat, I think. Oh, there's a jawbreaker by X-Pac earlier on. No, I think I'm losing my voice a little bit. There's a reverse sort of a face buster by X-Pac on my leg. That's where voices go really funny now. I'm going to have a drink before the next match, I think. See, Dean Malenko was crawling towards X-Pac, but X-Pac was back up to his feet before Malenko could get there. X-Pac sent him into that corner. Just seeing a few of the highlights. There's a potential dropkick there avoided by Malenko on X-Pac. And there's that great Hurricanrana by X-Pac. And I thought that was a... There you go. That's where the referee got caught. X-Pac hit the Hurricanrana on Malenko. Then Malenko sort of banged into the referee. You see, X-Pac then went the schoolboy on Malenko. But it was never going to count because Malenko's hands were underneath the rope. Running forearm by Malenko brings X-Pac back up to his feet. And went for that beautiful butterfly powerbomb into the pin. And that was enough to finish X-Pac off here this evening. So X-Pac has been eliminated in round number one of our Cruiserweight Championship tournament. Dean Malenko goes on. He will face the winner of our very next match, Eddie Guerrero versus Mikey Whipwreck. And like I said, there's a very good chance we could have a full Radical semi-final here this evening. But let's wait and see what happens. And here is the last of our first round matches. It's going to be Mikey Whipwreck versus Eddie Guerrero for the chance to face off against Dean Malenko in the semi-final. And here we go. I've had a quick drink and hopefully my voice is going to last through this match. As we're using Mikey Whipwreck in this competition, I'm not quite sure what to do with him in this universe mode, really. He can be involved in the Hardcore Championship, I should imagine. And obviously, he's a Cruiserweight as well. There's one problem I have with the Cruiserweight Championship. I'm going to probably recreate the Cruiserweight Championship myself. And I'm going to take off the Light Heavyweight rule. And then I'm just going to govern it. Because there were certain people that I wanted to have in this competition that I couldn't. Because the game was saying they weren't a Cruiserweight. So, we lost a couple of people I wanted to have in here, but it's not a major problem. We can work with what we've got. It's still a pretty good tournament, let's face it. We're gonna see a great Cruiserweight champion in our Attitude Era. A belt that I never really utilized in 2K15, and this time I'm really looking forward to using it. It's really gonna add an extra level to our 2K16 Attitude Era roster, and obviously our current day roster's got a Cruiserweight championship as well. It's an extra belt as well. Whoa. I turned into a demon there for a second. It's an extra belt there as well. So I think it's going to mean we're running 7 belts in the Attitude Era once we get the Women's Championship up running as well. So if we do like a Knight of Champions style pay-per-view, then we've got a full card basically. Big punch there by Eddie Guerrero on Mike Whipwreck. I'd have to say that Guerrero is the much stronger in this match. I think Whipwreck is almost a bit like it's going to be a bit like a jobber, I should imagine, in this tournament, and probably in WWE as well, really. I don't think he's the strongest guy out there, really. Although I do really like his shirt. That is pretty cool, that shirt. There's the Hurricanrana. He's hooked the leg for the pin as well. One. It's only a one count, and Eddie Guerrero reverses the pin. The first time we've seen that in this game in 2K16. That was something we saw a lot of in 2K15, and it did get really annoying seeing the pins get reversed over and over and over and over again in one of those sort of pin reversal paradox, paradigm, endless neverness sort of situations. I'm making up some random crap now as I go along, aren't I, really? Big clothesline there by Eddie Guerrero on Mikey Whipwreck. Brings Mikey back up to his feet. Like I said, there's a chance that I might start to use Whipwreck as part of maybe a stable. One of the members of Raven's Flock, maybe. Something that I would like to do is Raven's Flock. Have Raven alongside Mikey Whipwreck. And I'm thinking Tajiri as well. Tajiri was always somebody who I think was easily turned, I believe. I think Tajiri, and I think it might have been Tajiri, Super Crazy, and Mikey Whipwreck, I think, might have been a trio managed by James Mitchell towards the end of ECW. I might be wrong. But that's just something I seem to remember off the top of my head. There are other people in this competition that I've not actually, in this roster, sorry, that I've not used at all. There's the stunner by Whipwreck. One, two, and Eddie Guerrero kicks out. That would have been amazing, that. We would have lost Eddie Guerrero and Rey Mysterio, two of the stronger members of this competition in the very first round. That would have been a shocker, that would have been. Whipwreck went for a DDT, but Eddie Guerrero reversed it into the Russian leg sweep. Again, bringing Whipwreck back up to his feet. And are we going to see the trifecta here? There's one. Rolling the hips. Round for a second. Vertical suplex. Roll the hips once again. And there is the third of the suplexes by Eddie Guerrero on Michael Whipwreck in for the pin. Is this going to be enough here? One, two. It's not. Mikey Whipwreck kicks out. Guerrero can't believe it. I think it's going to take one or two more big moves to finish him off. But he's going to get a chance to hit them there as Whipwreck looks to take control of the match once again. Big knee to the stomach, and now Whipwreck goes up top. On a leg drop against the back of the head of Eddie Guerrero. Hurricanrana by Whipwreck. He's got the legs hooked. This could be all. One, two, and again, it's only a two count. Guerrero rolls through again. Two. Oh, we're on one of these. One, two. Oh my God, these exist on 2K16 as well. Oh no. I thought this was going to be one of the things that weren't going to exist. That's the first time we've seen it, though, so it's not too bad, I suppose, but that is something I used to get really frustrated with on 2K15. Just endless and endless pinning combinations. And Whipwreck has been a lot better in this match than I gave him credit for, I must admit. I thought Guerrero would have a much better time in this than he has done in a couple of my competitions already. Whipwreck with a snapmare now.
And there's a dropkick to the back of the head of Eddie Guerrero by Mikey Whipwreck. Whipwreck hands on hips. And he's not sure now what he needs to do to finish Eddie Guerrero off. Both these guys have had great chances. And I'm thinking Dean Malenko must be sat backstage now thinking his semi-final match is going to be pretty easy at this rate. Both these guys have taken quite a bit of damage. Guerrero now throwing Whipwreck into that corner. Whipwreck with that back elbow straight away. There's that snapmare. Dropkick to the back, missed by Whipwreck. Guerrero back up to his feet. Guerrero's shin breaker. See, a lot of people in this game seem to have the shin breaker as a move in their moveset. But I don't think I've ever really seen it being used in actual wrestling, that shin breaker. Let me know if you guys have ever seen it before. I don't recall ever seeing that move, but everybody on this game seems to have it in their moveset, but I've never really seen it used. Crucifix pin here. Oh, referee, your hand hit the mat 3 times again there. Your hand hit the mat 3 times, and we know, actually, just to go off on a slight tangent here, we already know that Eddie Guerrero is getting a shot at the European Championship on our very first episode of Friday Night Raw is War on our Attitude Era. So Eddie could have a chance to pick up a second championship if he can go all the way here this evening. Taking Whipwreck up. Power driver by Eddie Guerrero. Not a move he normally goes for, but either way, it looks to be effective here. And now looking for that submission hold. A version of a cloverleaf. I think he probably should have gone for the pin, really, because, like I've said before, submissions tend to struggle on this game. They're not the best, really. Oh, Mikey Whipwreck's been busted open. And yeah, I'm thinking now whoever wins this match is going to have a very, very difficult time getting through Dean Malenko because they're losing a lot of energy here. And poor old Mikey Whipwreck is now losing blood as well. Dropkick to the side of the head. Tripping Guerrero over there. In for the pin. 1, 2. Oh, it's only a 2 count. This match still continues on. Who is going to go through to face Malenko? Yeah, just for me, I think Malenko is going to have such a simple semi-final, and that's probably going to help him win the entire competition, really, because Malenko didn't use a lot of energy against X-Pac, really. Whipwreck went for like a power slam there, but Eddie Guerrero slides off the back and catches him with that reverse DDT. Whipwreck tripping Eddie Guerrero. Now just stamping on the back of the leg, rolling Guerrero over. Pulls him into the middle of the ring. And dropping an elbow onto the inside of the knee. Now, I do wish sometimes in this game they'd have a bit more idea of what they're doing. And this is another situation. I don't quite know what's going on. He just keeps walking backwards into the corner. And I think there's just still quite a few... little issues with the AI on the game. I know 2K said they've improved it, but sometimes the wrestlers in the ring don't seem to have an idea of what they're doing. They just seem to, like we saw earlier, Michael Whitrack rolled him over, pulled him into the middle of the ring, then rolled him back over the opposite way, which seemed a little bit pointless to me, but there you go. Back elbow by Whitrack, and then just sends Eddie Guerrero right over the top rope. And just to remind you guys, I have been doing all these tournaments since the very first couple. I've been doing them all on high momentum just to try and speed them up a little bit. And it just shows you that the momentum on this game, whereas in 2K15, it used to make the matches last like 30 seconds to a minute sometimes. On this, it doesn't have a huge amount of effect. It does speed up the rate of what they get their finishes, but it doesn't really speed up the rate of the matches. As this match has must have been going on now for clear over 10 minutes, surely. And maybe we could get a count-out victory here. Of course, it was a count-out victory that's earned Eddie Guerrero a chance at the European Championship on our first episode of Raw is War. I'm not going to say anything else on that one. Whipwreck on the top. Oh, great hurricanrana from the top. And
Oh, he brings him back up. Why haven't you gone for the pin, Whipwreck? Again, another Hurricanrana. Hooks the legs. One, two. And Eddie Guerrero has been eliminated in the first round by Mikey Whipwreck. God, this game, it really does throw up some interesting results, doesn't it? This is that electric chair. Very painful move that is. And then just wrenching back at the leg of Whipwreck as well. I dare say Whipwreck is definitely going to struggle against Dean Malenko in the next round. I think with the amount of damage he's taken so far, he's also been busted open by Guerrero as well. So although Whipwreck has taken away the possibility of having a Radicals match in the semi-final, that would have been great to see Malenko face off against Guerrero. But still, it's going to be Malenko versus Mikey Whipwreck in that semi-final. And we're going to have a very interesting first champion here, aren't we? I think Malenko is probably only one of the ones that I considered as a favourite in this one. The others have already been knocked out, which of course is Rey Mysterio and Eddie Guerrero. I'm assuming if you guys have had a guess in the comment section below, I'm assuming that sort of 90% of you have been wrong so far, because you probably picked the same as me. You probably went for your Rey Mysterio or your Eddie Guerrero. But unfortunately, we are all wrong. And that was probably what turned it around, was that big move there off the turnbuckle, catching Guerrero in the Hurricanrana, then followed up with a second Hurricanrana, hooking the legs for the pin. And it was enough to pick up the free count. Great win here for Mikey Whipwreck against the odds, and we're going to see him again later on this evening. I'm assuming he's going to have that cut in his forehead looked at first, though, because the more blood he loses, the more difficult it's going to become for him to carry on, really. And before we get into our semi-finals, let's just have a quick look at the brackets. So as you can see, our first semi-final is going to be Christian taking on Jushin Liger. And our second semi-final, as I just mentioned, will be Dean Malenko versus Mikey Whipwreck. And there we go. Like I just said, our first semi-final will be Christian versus Jushin Thunder Liger, who seems to have his horn cut off by the picture there. It's a bit annoying. And here we go. Who is going to go on and get themselves a place in the final, a chance to fight it out for the Cruiserweight Championship here in our Attitude Era roster? We are about to find out. We've got Christian and Jushin Thunder Liger in the ring for you now. Of course, Christian defeated against the odds Rey Mysterio in the first round. And Jushin Liger, of course, defeated Tajiri in that all Japanese first round match. Of course, we've seen Christian already in the Cruiserweight Championship tournament. This is the first time we've really seen Jushin Liger in these competitions, as he's got both arms hooked, takes him up into a big powerbomb. And like I say, damage retention is on, so these semi-final matches could go a lot quicker than the first round matches did. As Jushin Liger's trying to show us here, he's got a head of steam, tripping Christian over. And I thought that could have been it. He didn't go for the pin, decides to bring Christian back up to his feet. He's taken him up into a Liger bomb. There it is. And surely, Jushin Liger is going through to our final here this evening. He's destroyed Christian in the opening parts of this match. In for the pin he goes. One, two, and... What? How on earth has Christian got out of this? How on earth did Christian just kick out of that? Liger taking Christian up onto his shoulders. Taking him down. You're going to go for a pin once again. Another high impact move. And I think that could have finished Christian up. But, well, saying that, Liger seems to be stalking Christian. Is he looking for another high impact move here once again? He is. Taking him up. Brainbuster. Now, if Christian kicks out of that, I am Hitler. One, two, and three. Thank God for that. I'm not Hitler. But Jushin Liger is going on to our final here this evening to fight it out for the Cruiserweight Championship against either Dean Malenko or Mikey Whipwreck. And this is a much quicker match here this evening. There's the Liger bomb. And I cannot believe that Christian kicked out the Liger bomb anyway. That was a stunning one for me. But of course, Liger had enough left in his locker. You see, he just hit that big, almost like a sit-out scoop slam style move. And then instead of going for the pin, he just waits for Kristin to get back up and catches him in that big brainbuster, hitting both of his finishers in this very short match. And Jushin Liger is going on to our final here this evening. But who will he be facing off against? Will it be Dean Malenko? Will it be Mikey Whipwreck? We're going to find out next. And here is the second of our semi-finals. It'll be Dean Malenko taking on Mikey Whipwreck for a chance to face off against Jushin Liger in our final this evening. And here we go. Who will it be going on to face Jushin Liger for that championship later on this evening? I got my money on this match on Dean Malenko. I think Mikey Whipwreck received a lot more damage in that first round match when he had that long match against Eddie Guerrero. I think Malenko probably had a bit of a better time against X-Pac, that was it. But there's a big power driver by Mikey Whipwreck very early on. It happened. I knew it was going to happen at some point. I don't know if you guys saw that as well, but that happened right there, right then. And I'm going to show you right now. I don't know why he pulled him all the way to the corner here to hit his finishing move, but he did. Now, you watch the hand of Dean Malenko here. You see Whipwreck with a pin. One, two, hand on the ropes. Dean Malenko had his hand on the ropes. The referee did not see it. And Mikey Whipwreck picks up a victory here. And he's going on to our final. And that's been two very, very quick semi-finals here. And we're going to see Jushin Liger versus Mikey Whipwreck for the Cruiserweight Championship. Now, I'll tell you what, that is not a final that many people would have guessed would have happened in the comment section below. But let's get straight into it. And there it is, confirmation of our final match. It's Jushin Thunder Liger versus Mikey Whipwreck for the Cruiserweight Championship here in our Attitude Era roster for the WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. And here we go, we're in Phoenix, Arizona, and since this is a championship match, it means we are going to have the entrances here. And here he comes, it's Jushin Thunder Liger. And this entrance is actually suiting him pretty well. I like this. Some of the creator wrestlers have not got the best entrances, but this one seems to be working quite well for Jushin Liger, suits him. Yeah, this suits him perfectly. This is a perfect entrance for Jushin Liger. And I like the way the cape is acting exactly as it should. Almost strangling him, but that's probably exactly where it should be considering what he just did over the top rope. Cape finally sits back to where it should do. And that's one of the things I like they've changed this year is the fabric has got its own sort of mind, but it's exactly where it should be, really. Which is good, because last year, all the fabric just seemed a little bit solid. It didn't go really where it should do. So it does look a lot more realistic. And here comes Mikey Whipwreck. As you can see, he looks a little bit nervous here. This is his first big opportunity at a championship here in the WWE 2K16 Universe Mode. So I don't blame him for being a little bit nervous for this match. He's got to face off against the Japanese legend that is Jushin Thunder Liger. Slowly makes his way to the ring. Probably just trying to keep as much energy as he possibly can. Of course, shouldn't really be in this situation considering that Dean Malenko's hand was on the bottom rope when Mikey Whipwreck got the free count. So that's an interesting little sideline there. Should Mikey Whipwreck win this match, that could be something that we definitely have a look at, is a championship match maybe for a Dean Malenko. I think Dean Malenko should get a championship match anyway. I think he deserves it. That's what they're fighting for, the Cruiserweight Championship. Yeah, Dean Malenko... And I'll write this out of my notes now. Hand on the rope. So I think Dean Malenko should probably get a Cruiserweight Championship shot against the winner of this match. Of course, we're still building towards our first pay-per-view, which is going to be in week number 2 of our Universe Mode. So we need to try and build pretty quickly for that. And at the moment, we already know that the European Championship will be defended on the very first episode of Friday Night Raw is War. And we're pretty much going to have a Cruiserweight Championship match probably at the pay-per-view. When the winner of this match will face Dean Malenko, who was unfairly knocked out of this competition. Back elbow, beautiful there by Jushin Liger. Now with a big clothesline, going the punt to the back of Mikey Whipwreck. Back up to his feet, and now here we go, clotheslines by Jushin Liger. A trip as well. And Liger picking up a head of steam. Bringing Mike Whitrek back up to his feet, and Liger taking Whitrek up. There's the Liger bomb. Surely he has to pin him. Why did he stay in the pin? It took a bit too long, longer than he should. Now he's going in for the pin on Mike Whitrek. One, two, and three. And there it is. We have our first cruiserweight champion for our Attitude Era roster sorted. It's going to be Jushin Thunder Liger. And can you think of anyone better? An absolute Japanese legend, a several-time holder of the Junior Heavyweight Championship across in NJPW. I think it was NJPW. But definitely worthy of holding our first Cruiserweight Championship here in the Universe Mode. It's really going to be an interesting one. Again, a completely different champion to what we had last year on 2K15. It's a brand new championship belt as well compared to 2K15. So I'm really looking forward to this. There's going to be a lot of great competition for Jushin Liger. And I really can't wait to get the Universe Mode sorted now. And the game cuts me off again. I don't know why it does that. At the end of the tournament, it doesn't let you come out of the celebration yourself. You have to, it just cuts you out of the video straight away and brings you back here. But this is confirmation. The brackets here that Jushin Liger defeated Tajiri, Christian, and then Mikey Whipwreck in the final to become our first Cruiserweight champion here for the Attitude Era roster. Now, like I said, Dean Malenko was unfairly lost in the semi-finals. His hand was clearly on the rope. The referee missed it. Therefore, Dean Malenko will be given a Cruiserweight championship match against Jushin Liger at our very first pay-per-view in a couple of weeks' time. So be sure to keep an eye out for that. Now, of course, if you have liked this video, then be sure to slap that thumbs up button. It does help me out. And of course, slap the thumbs up button for Jushin Liger becoming the Cruiserweight champion, and just for how good that Jushin Liger core and the Dean Malenko and the Rey Mysterio and the Tajiri and the Eddie Guerrero, all those fantastic cores are. If you're not already, be sure to subscribe, because we'll be uploading a lot more daily 2K16 footage until middle of next year towards 2K17 probably. If you guys are still watching, then I'll keep creating. I've been Shabby Gamer. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you all next time.